Our next speaker is Kevin Tallant.
Evening, Commissioner. My name is Kevin Tallant. I'm speaking on behalf of my client, Metcam, Inc. I do not have a personal interest in the matter that was currently pending before you. What I want to do tonight is thank each and every one of you, and I know I'm not supposed to direct comments to any particular commissioner, and so I won't, but I think one commissioner probably thinks I've been stalking him for the past 3 weeks while I've been involved in representing Metcam, Inc. I am pleased to tell you that at about 40 seconds ago, we have an agreement in place which I believe will allow you to tonight unanimously pass the zoning request which is before you involving my client. I want to thank you. That's important for several reasons. Number one, my client employs right now approximately 160 people in this county. With the approval of this rezoning effort, he's going to be spending millions of dollars in this county as well, adding to our tax base, and ideally will be employing an additional 30 to 40 people when the expansion is finally completed. That is important because these are manufacturing jobs. And from all levels of our federal government down, the focus is placed on manufacturing jobs because, frankly, Americans want to make things. And what you are sending by passing this measure tonight is an indication that people can not only make things still in this country, but that they can make them right here in Forsyth County. And finally, the thing that I think is probably the most important is that by passing this measure tonight, which I believe will again be allowed to do unanimously, you're sending a message to people not only that we want you to bring your business here, but for a client like mine, which has been here for over 20 years, you're telling people not only do we want you to bring your business here, once you're here, we'll help you to continue to grow and we'll help you to continue to thrive and to contribute to our economy. So again, thank you on behalf of my client for your patience in dealing with me and my many phone calls over the course of the past few weeks. And thank you for what you're going to do tonight as a citizen of Forsyth County for helping us to continue to be a prosperous and wonderful place to live. I thought I was going to have things to hand to you. I'm going to have to make a quick revision, and then I'll get them to you at some point before the matter actually comes up. Thank you.
Thank you.
That was our final speaker, Mr. Chairman.
Which I believe takes us to old business. Number 1A, Metcam.
Yes, old business 1A, zoning application 3584, Metcam Inc., located in Commission District Number 3. The request is to rezone from M1 and A1 to M1 on 9.179 acres for the expansion and construction of an existing business in 152,084 square feet of total building space with 157 parking spaces. The applicant is also requesting the following variances: one, elimination of rear yard setback of 75 feet, two, elimination of rear yard buffer of 60 feet, three, to reduce the side yard setback to 40 feet, reduce the side yard setback of 40 feet to allow a 35 foot setback, reduce the side yard buffer 35 feet to allow a 25 foot buffer on the west side. These are in reference to UDC chapter 14-1.3, table 14.2.
Mr. Brown, he's got a couple of changes he's working on right now. You want to wait to put the new ones up, or
regarding the conditions,
get you a copy to read as well, and then do that? Can we take that?
I will finish the generic component of my introduction, and we'll know that the conditions are soon to be on the screen. The Planning Commission recommended approval of the rezoning from A1 and M1 to M1 with conditions. The current version of those conditions will soon be on the screen. And the public hearing was held on January 24th, 2012. Thank you.
You have the new conditions on the screen now. Okay.
Excuse me, could you focus that just a little better, please? Thank you. Thank you.
I
Mr. Chairman, I realize this is a last-minute introduction. If you'd like us to make copies of that, I'm glad to make copies and display it. It's entirely up to you.
Is there a page two?
Yes. Are all parties in agreement to the agreement?
Yes.
No?
Yes, sir.
District 3 Commissioner. Do you have a suggestion for it, perhaps?
Has anybody here on the board had a chance to look at this property besides me?
I've looked at lots of maps and aerials and deeds, but I haven't gone out there.
I'll just say this before I make a motion. Both sides were pretty far distance apart when this all came about. I got to give them thanks for working as hard as they have. Voluntarily postponed, and they had to really come in the middle on this one. I was perplexed as well with some of the things that were going on and the conditions they were asking for. However, now they've all come to agreements, and they're happy that I'm happy. I make a motion to approve the zoning changes for the ZA 3584 M1, from A1 to the M1, with the variances for the following. I'm not agreeing to get them to move off what Mr. Brown read to us, and approve them as also displayed on the screen.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Is there any further discussion about this motion? Please vote on the motion. And that passes unanimously. Thank you. Old business item number two is a discussion of the town hall meeting. It's the previous description from March 20. And I believe that Smartworth has asked for a new date.
Mr. Chairman, that is correct. They have a significant interest in this particular project, and they have requested the meeting be rescheduled. They have recommended a date of April 26th